I'm Molly Hague, and you're in the National Institute of Dental and Craniofacial Research. What I'm looking at is oral cancer, specifically of the tongue. So I'm doing experiments on oral cancer and with oral cancer cells. So I am originally from outside of Wichita, Kansas, a pretty rural area. And when I graduated high school, there were only 40 kids in my graduating class. So for my family aspect, I actually don't have anyone in dentistry. I am one of the first, or the first, of my immediate family. My sister actually lives in San Francisco. She's an attorney. My brother is a nurse. My mother is in education. And my dad is a CEO of an electrical contracting company. So we're all over the place. But I have had nothing but support from my family to pursue higher education. So when I graduated, I moved to Missouri, where I went to undergrad at Drew University. And after graduating, I moved to San Francisco, where I went to the University of California, San Francisco School of Dentistry. And I got tied into research because during undergrad, I knew I was interested in doing something hands-on, craniofacial development. So I moved to Kansas City for my summers during undergrad and did research at Stowers Institute. I have taken a part of a program, which is the NIH Medical Research Scholars Program, where I take a year off between my third and fourth year of dental school. And I've chosen to work in the NIDCR in Ken Yamada's lab and do research on oral cancer. It's absolutely fantastic. I've had a great time not only interacting with medical students, other dental students, and there's even a vet student a part of our program. So I've had a great time not only living on the NIH campus, interacting with the students, and then having the opportunity to be a part of a lab for a full year. So on a day-to-day basis, all of my lab stuff is surrounding me. I'll come in the morning and write out what experiment I want to run with my oral cancer cells. And I'll move forward in setting up those experiments and monitor them throughout the week or even into the weekend whenever I want to run them. And each day I'm checking on my oral cancer cells and maintaining where they're at relative to my experiment. So specifically, I'm looking at the invasion and metastasis of oral cancer. So I'm hoping to stop the invasion and metastasis, but setting up experiments in which these cells are running and I have to check them throughout the week. So my collaborators here in the lab are not only doing research on oral cancer, they're doing research on wound healing and looking at cells which are called fibroblasts. So these cells, they're looking at understanding different pressures, seeing how the cells really interact. So we're on the very first level of understanding the science of disease. So oral cancer, according to the NCI in 2014, there are estimated 42,000 cases in the United States and over 8,000 deaths. And so this is something that we can diagnose early and hopefully treat, but there's not an all cure for cancer. So it's something that we need to pursue and hopefully find an answer for. In 15, 20 years for oral cancer, I'm seeing that there's going to be a treatment that there will be no reoccurrence of cancer. There will be an aspect of someone has a lesion somewhere in their oral cavity, it's diagnosed, and then the patient has a treatment in which they'll be given that treatment and won't have the oral cancer come back again. The reason this is the best job in the world is that you get to be on the verge of new knowledge. You get to reach out to anything, any idea that you have, you get to look for it and find new cures, help patients. There isn't a better way to do that.